What's up, YouTube? How are you doing today? Chana D, your techno dad here. And in today's video, I'm gonna walk you through the Apple TV update that adds Dolby Atmos. So as you can see, the update is starting here. I had a graveyard shift on Sunday night. I knew the update was coming out Monday morning, so I stayed up way past my bedtime. 9 a.m., nothing. 9:30 a.m., nothing. Finally, 10:30 in the morning, update's here, and we are updating. Now the whole update takes about, 7 to 8 minutes, but we're just gonna kind of fast forward through all the nonsense. But I just wanted to do a quick little intro. All right, so here we go. This is what we get in the What's New screen. We have Dolby Atmos, aerials, passwords, and remote control. What are we most concerned about, at least me, is Dolby Atmos, because this is gonna be the world's first streamer that has the double D. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, Dolby Atmos and Dolby Vision. Yeah. All right, so let's get into some settings right now. Video and audio, and let's go down to audio format. Now this already says auto and Atmos available. So this is what you want it to look like. Change format is off, Dolby Atmos is on. If you change those around, change format will bump everything down to like a 5.1. We don't want that. We want Dolby Atmos, so make sure it's on. All right, now that's set, let's jump into a movie. I already have Transformers The First Night, which has both Dolby Vision and Dolby Atmos. So let's hit play and wait for this guy to boot up. This first opening scene, the Dark Ages. Let me press info, and here we are. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Dolby Atmos input signal and active speakers. I have all 9 active speakers going. Perfect. All right, let's go to another movie, shall we? Now this is an iTunes movie, of course. This is a movie app in iTunes. Let's go to Oblivion. It's supposed to have both. So let's check it out. All right, it's 36 seconds in. Let's hit info. And look at that, ladies and gentlemen. We do not have Atmos. We have PCM. And if you notice on the right-hand side, only 5 speakers are active. That's kind of strange. All right, let's bump out of here. And let's go to Lucy. I know this one's got to have Dolby Vision, Dolby Atmos. Yep, it does. All right, let's hit play. And here we are again, ladies and gentlemen. PCM signal, not Atmos, and only 5 channels are active. All right, so Transformers works, but the other 2 don't. Now, it was kind of strange, so I didn't want to make this video until later on Monday evening so I can figure out what's going on. Now, what I found out was not all of the iTunes movies that say Atmos are playing in Atmos right now, so we might have to wait for that. However, good news is a lot of the movies on Vudu are playing in Atmos, even though the description doesn't say Atmos. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 does have Atmos, and it will play in Atmos. Now, one thing we're not getting is Dolby Vision. Why are we not getting Dolby Vision? It's kind of weird. So let's go back to settings. Now, I don't know if this is going to happen for everyone, but for me, it looks like match content was turned off in the update. Okay, so that's that and Chroma 420, I had that set to 422. So we need to change that. So this is what it looks like, guys. Format 4K HDR and Chroma 422, and then match content range and frame rate. Range means dynamic range and frame rate means frame rate, because you want it to match the original frame rate of a movie, which is 24 frames per second. Once you have those selected, then we should have no problem getting Dolby Vision and Dolby Atmos. Like I said, after I did the update, it just kind of went ahead and put those to defaults, which we had to change anyway the first time I turned it on. So let's go back into iTunes Movies and into Transformers, and let's hit play and see what we get. And there we go, you can see at the top, Dolby Vision insignia comes on the Vizio TV here. And hit info on the Denon, and boom, we have Dolby Atmos and all 9 speakers are working. Fantastic. Now, this isn't limited to just the iTunes movies app. I did go ahead and jump into Netflix. Now, my go-to movie is Okja, O-K-J-A. It says Dolby Vision, it says 5.1, but when you actually hit play, guess what? you get Dolby Atmos. So I think the issue is that these apps just need to get updated. Once the apps get updated, I think all the information will say perfectly fine what is what. One of my viewers, his name is Jake, he emailed me about it after I had already figured out a few things. And he said that when he tried to buy a movie or watch a preview of a movie, it only comes in 5.1. But when you buy the movie, then he played it and then he got Atmos. So Jake, thank you for that info. He also just stated that he found some other titles are playing Atmos through Netflix on Apple 4K TV, but are actually labeled properly. So he just searched Atmos and there's a bunch of movies there. So there you guys go. Apple TV 4K has Dolby Atmos. It's not implemented 100% yet and apps need to catch up a little bit, but we do have Dolby Atmos functionality. We do have Dolby Vision functionality for that fabled double D. I know you guys are all after that double D, so it's finally here. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. If you guys liked it, go ahead, thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe. If you have questions, hit me up down in the comments. And that's it. All right, have a good one. See you next time. Peace.